Welcome to your all-active reserve and veterans TV series. This information education show has three goals. Tell who military veterans are, share about all organizations, auxiliaries, their programs, and officers at all levels, and tell about memorials in all the cities we serve in this network. The VA system, state and county officers, hospitals, and state homes are also featured. Please do check out our websites. Share your program ideas and concerns via the contact information on the show. We open each month's show with a patriotic theme. Welcome once again to Vets Visits on TV, and this is program 171 for the month of June. And this is my co-host,
Neil Doyle with Olmsted County Veteran Services.
And I'm Jerry Barnhart, the founder producer of the program. Again, so glad to have you with us for this first show of summer. Now, on to some dates in history. In 1775, the Merchant Marine was established. And on the 14th of June, it's Flag Day. And it's basically our features for this month, so we'll have more to say about that. The third Sunday of this month is Father's Day. And we might mention here that the 21st is the first day of summer. On the 25th in 1995, the idea was born for the Veterans Memorial. Here in Rochester, it was dedicated in 2000. Now, let's see, okay, and on the 25th in 1950, North Korea invaded South Korea. Now, Neil, what's our first feature?
Over the years, Vets Visits on TV has featured fantastic and varied efforts of local post honor guards. With June 14th being Flag Day, Jerry first attends the folding of a flag, which will then be presented to a sister of a six-year-old deceased member of the American Legion post by the Honor Guard commander. We'll then learn about just a few of their responsibilities.
Guard, present, hark! The because our comrade answered the call to arms, the United States government and Post 92 Legion in Rochester, Minnesota, I feel it an honor and a privilege to present to you this flag.
Good afternoon, sir, and your name is?
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Gene Iden.
And you are the commander of the Honor Guard.
I am the commander of the Honor Guard for Post 92, American Legion in Rochester, Minnesota.
How long have you had the position, Gene?
Gosh, you know, my predecessor, Lyle Gardner, had it for over 60 years, I believe. And when he passed away, the baton was passed to me, so... I don't know.
About three or four years
now, I guess. But I have been a member of the Honor Guard over the years, for many years. I came to Rochester in 1957 and was a band director at Lourdes and used to supply buglers for funerals to play taps. Uh-huh. And in the later years, in the 90s then, I kind of was able to get away from school and do it.
Mm-hmm. Because you're a band instructor in one of these schools, right?
That is correct. I was at Lourdes High School for 36 years.
36 years, okay. Well, then I guess you're qualified to play taps.
Well.
And many other
I might think I'm qualified, but I'm not sure anybody else does.
Sure. Now, some more about the flag presentation. What is the action when a veteran dies, whether he's a Legion member or non-Legion? Yes. What happens?
Okay, when a member of the armed forces dies, he makes arrangement to have an honor guard through the morticians at the funeral homes.
The family does, right.
Mm-hmm. And then I get a phone call, and I contact the members of the honor guard, and meet at the club, and then from there we go out to the cemetery and do our honors. Mm-hmm. Most of the men that you see in this picture, they're all dyeing their hair the same color, which
sure,
is great.
Right.
Because,
it's more distinguished.
The younger men, it's difficult for them to get out of work during the day to do these funerals. So most of the guys are of age. And we are busy. Mm-hmm. And in a 3 month period, or a 2 month period rather, I think we had 31 military funerals just here in our area. And this week, we did this presentation, and we have two funerals this afternoon, and we have another one tomorrow, and we've got another one on Thursday. So things happen in bunches, but we are busy.
The flag was presented today here at the American Legion Post only because Mrs. Shoneman, who received the flag, was not able to receive a flag down in Arizona where her brother died.
Okay.
And I kind of followed through as a chaplain, getting the card to her.
Yes.
But then we needed to go to the County Veterans Service Office to get the flag.
Oh, sure, yes.
Yes, so they saw the flag out here to the post. And now there's another part that goes to this flag because Mr. Hanneman was Hannenberger rather,
yes,
was a member of the post.
Okay, if you're a member of the post, then you get a display case to put the flag into.
Mm-hmm. And there'll be a little plaque.
I believe so.
Metal,
right. Yep.
Metal plaque.
That's correct, yes.
Giving his name and dates of service,
yes,
and things of that nature, which, of course, she will receive.
Yes, right.
His next of kin.
Yes. That is correct.
One more thing.
Sure.
Any guesstimate on how many American Legion members have served as Honor Guard personnel over the years?
Oh, my gosh. No, there's been over the years.
Post is over probably
many,
60, 70 years old,
well,
at least.
Well, like Mr. Lyle Gardner, mm-hmm, you know, for 60 years. Mm-hmm. And we have pictures on our walls of people that I don't even recognize,
sure,
because they were doing it even before I came to Rochester.
Yes.
So it's been an ongoing ceremony and an ongoing
I would put it above a tradition.
Yes, and it's a commitment.
Yeah, it's
the most important thing that our American Legion Post can do is to bury the dead.
Mm-hmm. And honor our military personnel who have honorably served their country. Yes. It's not done for anyone who does not have D214.
That is correct.
Well, thank you so much, Gene Iden, for sharing with us and representing the Honor Guard and all the other men who, in preparation for the two services you will have this afternoon.
Yes.
And Rochester is just a little over 100,000, so there are a lot of personnel that between you and the VFW.
Yes, and we do other things also.
Sure.
Like a new opening of a new school, we will raise the first flag.
Mm-hmm.
And we will, on Memorial Day, we visit, our group visits, I think, eight mm-hmm. cemeteries.
We visit, six or seven cemeteries?
Plus a ceremony at
the cemetery. We will program after the ski presentation.
Then we might be asked to present the colors at a football game. We might be asked to present the colors, at any time. And we try to honor all these requests.
Persons who are military,
that is correct,
who want to be a part of a very honorable experience for a military post, should look forward to being a part of the Honor Guard.
That's correct.
So our younger veterans, come on in, guys.
That's
and gals.
You're welcome.
And gals.
Love to have you.
Thank you again.
You're welcome.
Well, Neil, something special is happening in the County Veterans Service Officer Office.
Recently, we've came to learn that Brad Lindsay, the other co-host, has accepted a position with the State Department of Veterans Affairs as a senior director. He'll be supervising over 60 employees, and he'll be able to make a definite impact on veterans across the state other than just Olmsted County now.
That's great. So as we continue this series, you're going to be a head honcho from the service office, right?
Definite possibility, Jerry.
Definite possibility. I like the the completeness of that statement.
All right.
Okay. So what's our report for today?
The only thing new to share, Jerry, is the post 9/11 GI Bill is going to be taking some serious program changes effective August 1st, 2011 here. Basically, the housing rate that veterans receive for that is going to be changed to half of the national average. Before, it was based on E5 with dependents and their zip code. So that's the major change that's going to happen with the post 9/11 GI Bill. And it's also going to be prorated based on the rate of pursuit that the veterans attending post-secondary college.
Mm-hmm. Made quite a few changes from back in the early days.
Most of them for the better.
Definitely. Yeah. I know we got a straight $9.90 a month, and that had to cover everything, regardless of whether you had dependents or not. Okay, now we'll go on to our next feature. And lastly on this program, dedicated, of course, to our national colors. I have three short features for you. Hopefully you've heard and seen the Patriot Guard on their motorcycles, each with flags waving. Ever since the Kansas demonstration at a funeral of a soldier killed in action, the Patriot Guards have positioned themselves to protect the honor of our comrades. And my question is, why would the Supreme Court vote to support negative opposition to people that want to disrupt the funerals of our fallen comrades? Next, I taped this guard outing to show their patriotism, and we've used it oft times as an opener, and now here it is, a tattered old flag.
Is this the first time you've been to our little town? I said, I think it is. He said, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key said, watching it right and say, can you see? And it got a bad rip in New Orleans, Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on the way. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape, whatever shape she's in. For she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, we don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Some 10 years ago, Jason Davis of On the Road from KSTP, St. Paul, sent me several military features I could use at any time. In western Wisconsin, he reported on an American Legion honor guard sharing at a gravesite with flag presentation and taps, appropriate for today's program.
Across the country, tens of thousands of veterans die each year, and with every passing, there's one fewer to provide the time-honored tradition of a military funeral. Honor guards are often old men, World War II veterans, whose chests still swell as they stand to attention waiting to pay homage to another fallen comrade.
We're the greatest country in the world, the United States of America, and whoever's been in the service has always got that pride in her.
Elmo Johnson is 84 years old. Since his days as a private in Iwo Jima, he's played taps for servicemen and women who have died. Today, he and the honor guard from Black River Falls, Wisconsin, have come to say goodbye to local veteran Eugene Amo.
Your glorious warfare's past, the battle's fought, the race is won, and you are crowned at last.
The flag is folded, and after a 21-gun salute...
Ready? Aim, fire! Aim, fire! Aim, fire!
For the 1,016th time, Elmo Johnson plays taps. Even after participating in so many funerals and hearing taps played so often, it still moves these old soldiers.
It's because you know that's the end for the guy, and you know sometime it's going to be played for you too.
Firing squad, tits. Hut. Left feed.
Got a trail. It makes you feel really that you've done something worthwhile, like for instance today. It really makes you feel as though you've done something, you know, for the whole family.
Jason Davis, Channel 5 Eyewitness News, on the road, Black River Falls, Wisconsin.
Several years ago, Jerry was sent a poem by Mr. Dan Larson of Northfield, Minnesota, whom we thank. Jerry shares, "My name is Old Glory."
My name is Old Glory. I fly atop the world's tallest buildings. I stand watch in America's halls of justice. I fly majestically over institutions of learning and in the front of children's classrooms. I stand guard with power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for four freedoms, not just for U.S. citizens, but for all human beings. I am confident. I am proud. When I'm flown with my fellow banners, my head is a little higher, my colors a little truer. Still, I stand for equality and liberty for all nations. I bow to no one. I'm recognized all over the world. I am honored, I am saluted, I am loved, I am revered, I'm respected, and I'm feared where there is injustice. I have fought in every battle of every war for more than 200 years. I was flown at Valley Forge, Gettysburg, Shiloh, and Appomattox. I was at San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, in the Argonne Forest, Anzio, Rome, and the beaches of Normandy, in Bataan, Okinawa, Korea, Saigon, Vietnam. Know me. I was there. I am presently in the mountains of Afghanistan, on the hot and dusty deserts of Iraq and Pakistan. I led my troops. I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired, but my soldiers cheered me on, and I was proud. I have been burned, torn, and trampled on the streets by the angry ones of countries I have helped set free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I've been soiled upon, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of my own country. And when it's by those whom I've served in battle, it hurts. But I shall overcome, for I am strong. I have slipped the bonds of earth and stood watch over the uncharted frontiers of space from my vantage point on the moon. I have borne silent witness to all of America's finest hours. But my finest hours are yet to come, when I am torn into strips and used as bandages for my wounded comrades in the battlefield, when I am flown at half-mast, lie on the casket to honor my soldiers and them in the trembling arms of a grieving parent at the grave of their fallen son, daughter, and yes, a parent. I am proud. My name is Old Glory, and long may I wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
You're a grand old flag, you're a high-flying flag, and forever in peace may you wave. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the brave. Every heart beats true 'neath the red, white, and blue, where there's never a boast or brag. But should old acquaintance be forgot, keep your eye on the grand old flag.
Thank you.
My thanks to Guy Hammernick, our engineer, for providing the backdrop for the material which you've just heard. Well, Neil, that's the show for June. And we'll see you again next month.
Looking forward to it, Jerry.
Look forward to having you in our audience next month when we come back again for Vets Visits on TV. Thank you for joining us for this month's show. Seen in over 350 communities for over 3,500 half-hour periods. Our websites have additional information about the show and are updated bi-monthly. To contact us, you are welcome to use one of these electronic methods. For all ground mail with questions, suggestions for future programs, you may use this address. Our IRS nonprofit status is 501c3, Information Education. The Minnesota Commissioner of VA and these state-level organizations believe in and endorse Vets Visits. Join us next time, won't you, for Vets Visits on TV.